सो हेलो गाइस, वेलकम. दिस वीडियो इज़ अबाउट फ्रेमो पैनल इनसाइड योर कार्गो कंट्रोल रूम, और एज वी कॉल इट एज CCR. सो इफ़ ऑन योर शिप यू आर हैविंग फ्रेमो पंप्स, दिस पैनल विल बी देयर एंड इट विल बी देयर ऑलमोस्ट इन द सेम लोकेशन. एंड देयर द सेटिंग्स, द नॉब्स, एवरीथिंग विल बी ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर. देयर माइट बी एडिशन ऑफ वन और टू थिंग्स, बट ओवरऑल द व्यू ऑफ दिस पैनल विल बी सेम सिमिलर एंड द ऑपरेशन ऑल्सो विल बी सेम. So let's start. So this over here is called as jockey pump or sometimes called as feed pump. The purpose of this pump is to maintain hydraulic pressure in your lines and in your hydraulic system of at least 6 to 7 bar so that no impurities can come inside your hydraulic oil or hydraulic system. So that is why we never never stop this pump unless a senior officer or engine room specifically asks you to stop this. Otherwise never stop this pump. So beside this jockey pump here we have three power packs. So it depends upon ship size. If your ship is bigger, you might have four power packs, but generally I have sailed on three power packs only. So there are three power packs over here. Now, how would you start a power pack? To start a power pack, for example, if you need only one power pack out of these three, if you need only one power pack, what we will check is the running hours of the power pack. So as you can see over here, these three numeral values over here, these are the running hours of the power pack. So if you, example, if you want to start only one power pack, we'll start the power pack which have the least running hours. So example, we are over here, this power pack number 12976, this has the least running hours. So if you want to start that, we will start this particular power pack. On top of this, it's written power pack 1, power pack 2, power pack 3. So you can see that this over here is a system pressure setting knob. So make sure before you start a power pack, make sure it is turned fully anti-clockwise and it is on zero. The system pressure is zero. If there is no power pack running, then the system pressure must be zero. Once you start the power pack, slowly, slowly you can increase the system pressure while turning it clockwise. This over here is the dial where you can see that system pressure. And this over here is a hydraulic oil temperature. As we can see, it's for now it is 45 degree. At 60 degree, this Fremo system will give alarm, and at 70 degree the Fremo panel will trip. This is what generally happen. So that's why we also have to monitor the temperature of hydraulic oil. It should not go to 60 degrees, because at 60 degree it will give alarm, and at 70 degree the Fremo system will trip. So in normal practice we don't have to worry about this hydraulic oil temperature, as there is always a cooling going on from seawater to it. But in case if you are into in places where the seawater temperature itself is 30 or 40 degrees, then you might have to look into it. Or in place, if in place where the seawater temperature is 25 or 30 degrees, but if you are using all three power pack 1, 2, 3, if you are using those three power packs at system pressure of 200 bar, then it might happen that gradually, slowly, slowly, the hydraulic oil temperature might rise. So yeah, during those circumstances or during those situations, we have to worry about this hydraulic oil temperature. Otherwise, we don't have to worry about it. It's been taken care of by the seawater cooling. So over here, we have this alarms. That's the alarm for this Fremo panels on the left side of it. HP oil shielding, system pressure low, then oil level high, oil level low. So these are the alarms which are there for this Fremo pump. So these alarms will come in your CCR, and they will also come in engine room. So both the places, if you get any alarm, both the places the alarm bell will ring. So over here we have push buttons and lever for the tanks. So from here we can start the cargo pumps for each tank. So to start this, as we see, we have to push this button as the light is on, and then slowly increase the lever. On the left side of it, we can see these are the pressure, 100 bar, 200 bar and 300 bar. Maximum what I have seen is we have run maximum pump to 200 bar, not more than that. This is what I have seen. Now to start, run the pump, push the button and slowly increase the lever. You can slowly, slowly increase the lever. As you can see, now I'm increasing the lever. There is no pressure on the side of this bar gauge because there is no power pack running. As there is no power pack running, all three power packs are shut. So even if I increase this lever to 100, nothing will happen because there is no power pack running. So I will stop this. So that's how you can see for each tank. For example, now on my ship, present ship, I have 20 tanks. So I have 20 push buttons with their gauges. So guys, now I will show you how to start a power pack and how to start a cargo pump. So as I told earlier, there are two things which you must do before starting a power pack. First is you check the power pack which has the least amount of running hours. And the second, after checking the running hours, you call engine room and confirm with them, can you start the power pack or not. So as practically in our case, power pack number 3 has the least turning hours, but we cannot start because engine room has told they are doing maintenance. So presently we will start power pack number 1 and 2 because of engine room. Otherwise in normal condition, we would have started power pack number 3. So make sure before starting power pack, your system pressure set knob is turned fully anti-clockwise. Means so that there is no pressure surge suddenly. So now I have checked that the system pressure is turned fully anti-clockwise. Now I will press this power pack number 1 start button. You see the current suddenly went up and it came down. The light is blinking. We'll wait for this light to stop blink. And once it has stopped blinking, then we will check which is the system pressure. The system pressure is steady at 100 bar. So this is the least pressure. So now I can check this is the least pressure. So again, when I told earlier that for starting a power pack, we have to be in least pressure. So power pack for power pack number 1, we were least at 0. For power pack 2, I cannot make it 0. So we have to be at minimum. So this 100 is minimum over here now. So now I will start power pack number 2. And so again, press the start button. The light will blink. The motor current suddenly went up. And I'll also wait for this light to stop blinking. And then after it has stopped blinking, I will wait for some time, confirm that the system pressure is okay. There is no rise or fall in the system pressure. And then after I will slowly increase my system pressure. So now I've started both the power packs. So, and the system pressure was least. Now I will slowly start turning the knob and will start increasing the pressure. After starting two power pack, we can wait for maybe 30 seconds. And then we will slowly increase the main pressure by this main pressure knob. And as per the Framo makers, they say normally keep it up to 150 bar. So that is an average that initially you must keep it to approximately around 150 bar. As of now, none of my pumps are running. So I've kept the pressure at 150 bar. And now I will start my pumps keeping the pressure at 150 bars. So now here I'm going to start 9 port and 9 starboard. But before starting any pump, make sure that your discharge valves are shut. So after making sure the discharge valves are shut, you can start these pumps. Either you can start one by one or you can start simultaneously. But if you are new to this Framo pump, do not start simultaneously. But if you are familiar with this pump and if you have worked on this, then you can start two pumps at a time, making sure that both pumps pressure are equal. So here as I've started two pumps, both the pumps I will try to make sure that the both pumps pressure are equal, and I will gradually increase both the pumps pressure at same time. So here you can see I'm increasing the pressure. I'm going to take it to maximum 80 bars, and then at 80 bars I would allow it to run for 30 seconds and then I will open my discharge valve. So that's it guys. Now I will open my 9 port and 9 starboard discharge valve and I will continue discharging. So that was the basic with respect to Framo panel inside CCR. Rest all things, how do we increase the pump pressure, which pumps to increase, which pump to decrease, what do we monitor inside CCR while discharging, that I will explain you in my later video when I will make a video on discharging operation on chemical tank.